On May 14th of 2023, just after 9 p.m. local time, a major landslide began a few miles north of the infamous Mount Saint Helens volcano. What started as a small slide soon snowballed in size until a swath of ground 765 feet long and 450 feet wide gave way, traveling downslope at a speed of 40 miles an hour. 22 seconds later, a massive wall of rock plowed through not only a section of State Route 504, but also a bridge that overlaid a local river, instantly destroying it. This landslide subsequently continued onwards for another 14 seconds until it finally came to a stop 2,500 feet from where it originated. It is now 7.5 months later, and we can see the full extent of the damage the landslide caused. But first, what happened to the 12 people, 1 dog, and 7 vehicles which were cut off, and when will this break in the road be repaired? The 12 people and 1 dog were rescued the morning following the slide at 9:30 a.m. As for the cars, repair crews made a temporary road above the bridge collapse site which allowed for the cars to be driven away 2 months later. However, this temporary road subsequently failed in November, and now it will likely take until the summer of 2026 until a new bridge is built. However, since sections of underground power lines and other wires were also destroyed with a landslide, it will likely take until May of 2027 until the Johnston Ridge Observatory is reopened to the public. However, not all of the damage simply occurred along the 2,500-foot-long path of this 210,000-cubic-meter landslide. Additionally, thousands of trees were felled as a result of the landslide up to 3.5 miles beyond where its forward motion ceased, and also the slide caused a section of the local South Coldwater Creek to change course. All of this more distant damage occurred due to the frequent remobilization of hundreds of thousands of tons of loose rock and sediments by river water, causing large quantities of material to be deposited miles downstream. This rapid and very thick deposition is what wiped out thousands of trees, especially along riverbends, and is also why the path of South Coldwater Creek diverted 700 feet to the west, as what was previously a pristine waterway became filled with sediment which blocked the natural flow of water, causing it to divert elsewhere. This whole ordeal offers a pristine example of not only what happens when increased sediment is input into a river channel, but also a type of volcanic hazard which some people overlook. Although not a perfect example of such, what is being referred to as the South Coldwater Slide is an example of a so-called cold Lahar. For comparison, traditional hot Lahars are directly caused by a volcanic eruption when hot volcanic material, typically due to large-scale pyroclastic flows or lava flows, melt snow and ice, or when a section of a liquid-filled crater lake is cleared, causing it to rapidly cascade downslope. Such Lahars are the third leading cause of death during a volcanic eruption, only falling behind pyroclastic flows and tsunamis. Yet, sometimes Lahars not associated with a volcanic eruption can occur long after a volcano has stopped erupting, and this is especially true if a recent eruption deposited large amounts of loosely consolidated ash and rock. Although not always the cause, when a heavy precipitation event strikes the region, there is always a chance that a large chunk of water-soaked loose volcanic material will start moving downslope, eventually mixing with river water to form a mudflow which can be equally as destructive as a hot Lahar. These cold Lahars can strike within weeks, months, years, or even decades after a volcanic eruption, with the latter being the case at Mount St. Helens in 2023, 43 years after its last major eruption. The South Coldwater Slide began in the thick layer of highly altered sediments and rock which were composed of ash deposits, pyroclastic flow deposits, and sections of the massive debris avalanche Mount St. Helens produced in 1980. All of these, when clumped together, acted as an unstable mass highly prone to motion which was finally triggered when high volumes of snowmelt soaked into the ground due to a regional heat wave. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.